Welcome, this is my brief instructional video for solving a composite quadratic function. Actually, we're going over the first and last problem in the practice set. So, here we go. 2x squared minus 16 equals 0. So this is a composite function because there's only one variable expression. There's the x squared. Okay, if this was a 16x here, there'd be two variable expressions. Would not be a composite function. We would want to use another technique like factoring because x will be common then. Okay, but since I notice this is a composite, I ask myself, hey, how's this guy put together? Well, number one, for x, we're squaring it, then we're multiplying by 2, and then we're adding the negative 16. So I'm going to solve it by going in reverse order, doing the inverse of each step. So I'm going to add positive 16, divide by 2, then take the square root. So we add positive 16 to both sides, so we get 2x squared equals 16. And then we're going to do the inverse of multiplying by 2, which is divide by 2. So we get 1x squared equals 16 divided by 2, which is 8. And then we're going to take the square root. So x equals plus or minus the square root of 8. And then 8 factors to 4 times 2. So this is really plus or minus the square root of 4 times the square root of 2. And the square root of 4, that simplifies to be 2. So final answer, x equals plus or minus 2 times the square root of 2. So total time in the video so far, less than 1.5 minutes. These problems are very straightforward. Composite functions are cool. You should be thinking, yes, composite function. This is very straightforward. I can do this. Okay, last problem. All 10 problems on the practice sheet are the same kind of problem. They're in the same format. So here we go. Again, composite function. So what are we doing to x? Well, number one, we're squaring it. And then it looks like we're multiplying by 3. And then we're adding negative 8. So again, if you can read math, that makes it way easier for your life here. So we're going to add positive 8 to both sides. So 12 plus 8 is going to be 20. So we get 3x squared equals the 20. Then we're going to divide by 3. So we get x squared equals 20 divided by 3. And then we're going to take the square root. So x equals plus or minus the square root of 20 over the square root of 3. Now you can see half the work here is just simplifying the radical. Solving was not the biggest issue going on here. Now, what's the square root of 20? Well, just like the, but square root of 20 is square root of 4 times the square root of 5. And the square root of 4 is going to simplify. That's going to be rational. That's just going to be 2. So this is plus or minus 2 square roots of 5 divided by the square root of 3. Now, here's the thing is, we want to rationalize the denominator. So we want to get to the radical in the denominator. So the way we're going to do that is, we're going to multiply by 1. So I'm going to get the same number, just in a slightly different form. So what would rationalize radical 3? Well, multiplying by radical 3. So radical 3 times radical 3, that'll make plain old 3 in the denominator. So I multiply by 1 in the form of radical 3 over radical 3. And up here, we're going to simplify those. Those are both primes, so there's no way to actually do the square root there. So that's going to be plus or minus 2 times the square root of 15. And then radical 3 times radical 3 in the denominator makes plain old 3. Now the denominator is rationalized. Last thing you need to do here, which doesn't, it's not going to happen on this problem, but you need to check to see if these rational numbers reduce. And so this is 2 over 3 that does not reduce, so I'm done. Boom. Okay, I hope that was instructional for you and gives you a clue on how to do these problems. Good luck.